positive comparison. Let me explain. They are two friends, and all of a sudden, this friend becomes so great. Then this friend begins to stand there. Now, in order for you to get growth and increase, you've got to use comparison in a good way. So, as a human being, when you see another person succeeding, say to yourself, ah, my friend was just like me. But if God was able to do it for her, I believe God will also do it for me.
That's right.
So the moment you see your friend, shake her hands, and say congratulations. And say, tomorrow by this time, I'll be like you.
Lord.
This is, oh, I can feel somebody.
Jesus.
This is how life is supposed to be. But unfortunately, we see people are doing great as our competitors negatively. Competition itself is not bad. Competition itself is not bad. But if it's positive, it is good. But if it's negative, it's bad. But another person will say, I even went to a good school more than her. My family is even better than her. Where did she get it from? Get ready on you. Say, do you see John Tintin Sano?
That's right.
Let me tell you, with this kind of comparison, you can never see greatness.
That's right.
Because in life, you can never get what you criticize.
That's right.
You can never get what you
criticize.
You can never get what you
criticize.
Whatever you dislike, you can never get it. So I want to advise everybody. And listen, when God makes your neighbor great, it's an example for you to know that it's around you. Why? Because if God bless, I like what I'm about to say. Can I tell you?
Yes, sir.
Because if God bless, can I tell you?
Yes, sir.
Because if God blesses your neighbor, it means the blessing is in the neighborhood.
That's right.